した顔してんな。What a waste.
We going?
Oh, it's Kaito. I just sent you the photo. Later.
So this is Ishimatsu, huh? Gray suit, gloves. We should be able to tell when he's leaving from here. Once he takes us there, we'll be ready to raid the lab. You good to go?
Yeah, let's do it. We're in position, Kaito-san. Tell Kido to make the call.
Gotcha.It's time for your big acting debut, buddy. You there, Tak? Kido's call went off without a hitch. Ishimatsu's on the move.
Great. Now we just have to find him and follow him.
Don't fuck this up, man.
Don't worry. Me and Sugiura got it covered. Gray suit, gloves. That's him.
No one.
on guard.
Yeah. Thankfully, that makes him stand out even more.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I understand. I'll be right there. No one.
Monsieur Lee?
It's a love hotel that closed down years ago. Perfect place to set up a mad scientist lab.
Kaito-san, it's me.
You find the place?
We've got a building that looks the part, at least. We're gonna head in.
Be careful, man.
Yep. Let's do it.
Right. We going?
Jeez, it's dark. What's the deal with this place?
Hey, do you think this counts as trespassing?
More or less.
Who the hell are you?
Yagami-san, what do we do?
Only one thing to do. We fight!
Bet those weren't the last of them, Yagami-san. If anything, that was just a welcoming party.
They'll know we're here, too. Probably have weapons next time. Guns, worst-case scenario.
Who are these guys, anyway?
Bums off the street, if I had to guess. Ichinose must have offered them a lot to do this.
Yo, you guys okay in there?
Yep, we're right on track. They've got guards, too. There's gotta be something here.
Something like a secret lab, maybe?
It'd be the perfect place. It's so dark, you could carry a corpse in here and nobody'd ever know.
Think you two can handle it on your own?
Actually, I just thought of something. Can you call Mafuyu for me? Get her over here. And tell her to bring the cops.
Huh? Why?
Well, think about it. We're trespassing, yeah? Even if we do stumble on Shono's secret lab, the court would never accept evidence found illegally.
And calling the cops makes it all fucking better?
Not exactly. Even they can't investigate without a warrant.
Then why the hell are you trying to get Mafuyu shot over there?
I've got an idea. Just talk to Mafuyu for me, okay? We'll keep looking for the lab.
Got it.
Dark.
Hold on. We shouldn't go in there without a light. Who knows what's gonna be in here? Let's be careful.
Damn it. I stepped in a puddle. For a door that doesn't even open.
Didn't I tell you to be careful?
I really like these shoes, too. Sugiura. You're gonna give me a heart attack.
Sorry.
What is it this time? Sugiura? This isn't funny, man. Where are you? Almost there. Nice. Almost there. That'll do it.
Sugiura!
The hell? Can't you see I'm trying to have some fun here? Give him 3 minutes, then he's just another body!
One man.
Don't mention it. Come on, let's keep going.
like this! Now's my chance.
The line. This is it. This has to be Shono's secret lab.
You two! What are you?
Shono.
Didn't think I'd find you working at the scene of the crime. Guess our timing's pretty good. Sugiura. Get some video of this place.
Stop that!
So all those Yakuza who got their eyes gouged out, you did it here, huh? Can't wait to see what turns up. The cops are gonna have a field day in this place. The victim's fingerprints, hair, bodily fluids, DNA. Can you imagine? Just how long I've been waiting to see evidence like this come to light.
I don't know what you're...
Sugiura, what's wrong?
I'm sorry, Yagami-san. I've been lying to you about everything all along, until now.
What do you mean by that?
I'm not actually ex-Kajihira. That wasn't the truth. Neither was my name. Yagami-san, I actually know you from a long time ago. That's the whole reason I approached you. My real name, Yagami-san? Fumiya Terasawa.
Terasawa?
I'm the younger brother of Emi, who this bastard murdered.
Sugiura!
Nobody move!
You in the hood! Drop the knife! Now! You're under arrest for attempted murder.
The cuffs won't be necessary. He's no longer a threat. Don't worry about your friend. We won't bother prosecuting him.
Oh, yeah?
No crime was committed here.
But sir, we can't just...
You need to get forensics in here. There's a good chance a series of murders took place in this very room.
And what brings you to say that?
Kido told me about it.
Unfortunately, we'll need a stronger premise than that. They would never issue a warrant on such grounds.
Well, then it's a good thing I have a better reason lined up.
Which is what?
Trespassing charges against a rogue ex-lawyer. Which makes this a crime scene. Guess you'll have to block it off. Preserve the evidence, you know?
Yagami-kun.
How clever. You don't mind being arrested if it means helping your investigation. I suppose this was your plan from the start. That's why you had Fujikun get the police involved. You surprise me.
Out of the way! Let me through!
Vice Minister Ichinose!
This place is under the Ministry of Health's jurisdiction. I demand you leave here at once.
Huh. I didn't realize you guys were in the love hotel business, Vice Minister.
It's a laboratory. Our top secret research facility for AD9. You have no idea of the fallout this could cause.
Then let's find out. If you didn't notice, I just trespassed. Meaning, this whole laboratory is a crime scene now. Isn't that right?
I'm not sure that's going to work, Yagami-san.
At least 4 people were murdered in here. I'm sure of it. The proof's right here in this room. So please, I'm begging you to help me here.
What a conundrum. You see, none of that is my concern.
What?
Hey. You should be thanking your lucky stars we haven't beaten the crap out of you by now.
Shit, almost makes you feel bad for the poor guy. Even if he deserves it. You smoke?
Man, you're as soft as ever, Kaito Aniki.
Hi.
Humor me. According to you, this is a secret research facility for AD9. Yes, Vice Minister?
That's correct.
Our nation's government has invested countless resources into AD9. It would seem rather foolish if we were to stop its momentum over this. I'm willing to overlook it for AD9's sake.
What?
But, sir...
Many thanks. Truly, I am in your debt.
Of course, Vice Minister. Now, everyone is to evacuate the premises at once. I hope you can continue your research into 89 without any more disturbances. Let me assure you, Dr. Shono, this will not happen again.
Is that so? Meaning? You're working for 89-2, aren't you, Chief Prosecutor?
It's time for you to go home, Yagami-san.
Just how long have you and Morita been working together?
AD9 has many influential supporters. There's no stopping our momentum.
Bullshit, there's not. I am not gonna let you win that easy.
Oh yes. I should let you know that I just received a call from Director Kido. Kuroiwa sends his regards.
Kuroiwa?
Apparently, he rescued Kido. He's been freed. Local thugs have made Kamurocho too dangerous for him.
The AD9 conspiracy entangled the ADDC's director, Kido, the same man who had unveiled it to the world. An unfinished drug that exacted human sacrifice. Yagami believed he had finally found definitive proof. But even that was swallowed by the darkness. All for the greater good of a drug that would save humanity.
You look worse than I was expecting. I hear Kuroiwa paid you a visit.
Yep. Just him and that baton he's got. Beat the shit out of us.
He took Kido, too. How'd things go with your stuff?
We found Shono's lab, but the police are basically refusing to investigate it.
Why?
Chief Prosecutor Morita's defending 89.
You for real?
Whatever evidence was there is probably long gone by now.
Yagami-san.
Right. There's something else I need to tell you, too.
What is it? This have something to do with Sugiura?
Yeah, that's not actually his name.
Huh? So you're Emi Terasawa's little brother, huh?
Why'd you keep it a secret?
At first, I wanted to make Yagami-san remember.
Remember what?
How he let my sister suffer. In my eyes, he was a scumbag who let a murderer walk. The murderer who then burned Emmy to death.
Damn, that's heavy.
Go on. You don't have to hold back.
Back then, I was just a shut-in fuck-up. My life was in shambles. Emmy was still there for me, though. When nobody else was. And then, somebody murdered her. Someone as nice as Emmy. Dead, for no reason. But the world doesn't stop for that shit. It just keeps turning, and people go about their business. Over time, I started to hate what our whole society stood for.
So, I'm guessing that's what led you to start that burglary ring?
Pretty much. At the very least, I didn't want to keep living my life for other people. You know, when Emmy died, Yagami-san didn't apologize. Not to me, or to my parents.
So that's when you guys first met, huh?
Yup. Looked totally different back then, though. Had glasses and long hair, so couldn't really see my face.
That's why I didn't recognize you. Defending a murderer? You're just as guilty as he is. Those words cut deeper than you probably could have imagined. Even so, Okubo insisted he didn't do it. And since I was his lawyer, I couldn't apologize. That would essentially be admitting he was guilty.
What about after the trial?
I didn't apologize then, either. Instead, I ran away. Put it all behind me.
Right. You didn't just walk away. You practically got disbarred. At least Okubo was getting the death penalty. It didn't feel good, but I settled for that.
Then why'd you start hanging around Talk again?
Because he found his way back to the courtroom to deal with all this mole business. Even got a Yakuza captain off the hook.
Well, it's not like I suddenly just became a lawyer again.
Sure seemed that way from my perspective. So, I wanted to see where your head was at. Find out if you'd forgotten what you did to Emmy. If you were gonna pretend like nothing happened, I'd make you remember. And I'd make you pay for it.
And that's why you approached me.
Yep. I wanted to know what Okubo was up to, too. Find out if he was as afraid of death as he should have been. If anyone was gonna go see him, it was you.
But now, it's looking more and more likely Okubo was framed.
And I never would have known if I hadn't teamed up with you. Ironic, huh? 3 years later, the real killer's finally clear. Now it turns out, Shono, he's the one leading the charge to cure Alzheimer's. He gets to go down in history as a hero? For what? Stabbing my sister to death? Burning her body?
Don't worry. Everyone will see him for who he really is once the truth gets out.
You weren't there today. The whole fucking system is protecting him. He bent the truth. Suppressed evidence right in front of me. What's the point of fighting that kind of battle, huh? It's bullshit! You saw it too, right, Yagami-san? Right?
Look, Sugiura. Ever since Emi-chan died, I've been running away from the truth. I was worried. Worried I wasn't gonna like what I found, that maybe I was responsible for her death. It was killing me. I couldn't bring myself to face it all.
Talk.
If you ask me, everyone has something they're trying to hide from themselves. But sometimes facing your fears is the only way forward. real reason you came to me is because deep down, you wanted to know the truth. That sound about right? If that's still true, we have our work cut out for us. We're gonna chase the truth as far as we can, even if it's in vain.
Yeah, but all our paths are blocked.
Who the hell cares? We'll blaze our own path then. Right, Tok?
Yeah.
You guys are out of your goddamn minds.
It's Mafuyu. What's up, Mafuyu?
I need to speak with you about Morita.
Wait, you're still here in town?
Yes. I'm waiting at Tender. Do you think you could come meet me here? I think I'm being followed.
What?
It felt like someone was watching me all the way to the bar. I don't believe I'm imagining it.
More of those bums the Ministry of Health hired?
Or maybe one of the chief prosecutor's men.
All right, I'll be right over.
Thank you.
I'm coming with. Higashi, keep an eye on Sugiura while we're gone.
Huh? Why do... fine.
Let's hit it.
Guys,
let's roll, Tom. Wait up, Tom.
Thanks for coming. How did it look outside? Did you see anyone suspicious?
Not particularly. Seemed fine to me.
Mind if I sit?
What happened to your face?
What? This? It's nothing.
You said you wanted to talk to me about Morita?
Yes. Specifically about how he acted tonight. It's hard to imagine the Morita I know doing that. It's almost like he's a different person. Almost like he cared more about politics than the law.
Not surprising. He's right in the middle of this 89 mess.
Thing is, Morita is the reason I decided to become a prosecutor. When my mother was killed in a hit and run, he was there to give me courage, show me a way forward.
I've heard.
That said, as for why he has an interest in protecting 89, I might have an idea.
Hmm?
About 10 years ago, something happened to his family. Perhaps that's what changed him. Made him look the other way on this.
What happened?
Hold on. I'm not entirely sure my theory is correct. It wouldn't be fair if I misrepresented the facts. However, I just spoke to a former police detective who handled that case. I'm about to get the case file from him.
Where?
We're meeting at the children's park. But it felt like I was being followed, so I didn't want to go alone.
So, that's our job here? We're your bodyguards?
Yes. At least, that was the plan. But seeing what already happened to you...
You think a couple of scratches are gonna slow me down? We'll do it. Right, Tak?
If you let us see the case file, what do you say to that?
Of course.
It's a deal, then. We'll be your escorts.
Oof, that's cold. Extorting the poor girl? Guess chivalry's dead, Mafuyu-chan.
Are you ready? The detective is waiting for us.
Yeah, let's do it.
Thank you. Well, do you see anyone?
Not yet.
There. Guess you were right on the money, Mafuyu-chan.
Looks like they want to fight, too.
Yep. Those aren't let's chat over some coffee faces.
So what, are they gonna follow us the whole way like that?
What should we do?
You back off a bit. We'll take care of them.
Let's go, Kaito-san.
You've got this!
Mafuyu! Not happy!
Thank you, Yagami-kun. Keep going!
Hell yeah!
What? No love for me, Mafuyu-chan?
Hang in there too, Kaito-san!
Now we're talking! Alright, Mafuyu-chan's watching, so let's not screw this up!
Damn it!
Hang in there, Yagami-kun!
This is the place. He should already be here.
You said he's an ex-detective, right?
Yes.
Let's hit it.
Uzawa-san, yes?
Yep. That's me.
Huh?
Huh?
Huh? You're the detective from before.
Oh shit, Yagami.
You used to be on the force? How'd you end up so scruffy?
I gotta ask you the same thing.
You two know each other?
Why'd you bring these chowderheads along?
Yagami-kun, he's sort of my boyfriend.
What? Since when?
It's not like that.
Then why are you blushing? It's comedy hour over here.
So, what do we have in the case?
10 years ago, Chief Prosecutor Morita's older brother strangled their mom to death.
But why?
A caretaker murder.
Their mother was over 70 at the time, afflicted with a severe case of Alzheimer's.
And they were taking care of her.
Yeah. It's hard to say what a dementia patient will do if you take your eye off them, even for a second. She apparently used to leave the stove on after she cooked or wander out in the middle of the night. None of the homes had any openings for her either. Ultimately, Morita's brother took care of their mom by himself.
Seems he put the burden entirely on his own back. He quit his job and moved in with their mother, all to ensure Morita was free to do his duty as chief prosecutor. He barely took breaks, barely slept, for 7 whole years before the incident.
All he got from his mother in return was abuse. Verbal and sometimes physical.
The hell'd she do that for?
It's a side effect of dementia, though not all patients exhibit it. Some cases can be suppressed, but it doesn't always work out.
At the time of the incident, Morita's brother was in the midst of a serious mental breakdown. I had to guess, he'd probably been about to break for months.
And the result was him murdering his own mother. Whatever became of him after all that?
Not long afterward, he tried to hang himself and failed. So they suspended his sentence until he was more stable.
And where is he now?
It says here he died a year later, by his own hand.
Dude.
After everything his brother did, Morita was removed from the spotlight for a while. But it seems that's all in the past now. Everyone recognizes him as an unquestionable leader on the Force.
So then, Morita blames Alzheimer's for all the suffering his family faced?
Most likely, yes.
The tragedy could have been prevented if only 89 had existed at the time. And once it does, who knows how many situations just like it could be avoided.
With a tragedy like that, no wonder he's defending it.
He's sure as hell not in it for the cash. Not for reputation, either. The guy's just doing what he thinks needs to be done.
I suppose I can understand that.
Huh? You can?
Huh?
You think that excuses everything that monster has done? He framed Ayabe, turned a blind eye to Emi-chan's murder, left Okubo-kun out in the cold. All because this fucking drug needs to get fast-tracked? How can you begin to think that's right? How? If Morita can decide what needs to be done, then so can we. I'm gonna protect every last person they've trampled. I'm gonna get revenge for Emi-chan.
Interesting.
What is?
Oh, it's just, really obvious you used to be a lawyer.
Used to? I've still got my badge.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, Lay off the gambling, yeah? You lose more than you win.
Yeah, whatever you say.
Yagami-kun, I think it'd be best if you hold on to these files.
You talk. Make sure she gets home safe, would you?
Hey, since we're close, do you mind if we drop in on Saori?
Oh, sure. What's up?
Oh, no reason. She just likes seeing the two of us together.
What now? Whatever. I was gonna go fill her in on what happened tonight anyway.
Why?
Kido never would have ended up in Kamurocho if not for Saori. And her honey trap.
A honey trap? You can't be serious.
Yagami-san, I didn't realize you'd be stopping by.
Awfully suspicious. Just what were you two up to in here?
Not much.
Guess we should go then.
Hey, how did everything go with Kido?
Hold on. I want to know what you two were up to first.
Well, Hoshino-kun was just...
Okay. This is all just a big misunderstanding. Or maybe not. Or maybe it is.
Maybe you'll get further next time.
Is it just me, or is Saori-san enjoying this?
Oh, yeah.
I've heard. It's horrible what happened to Morita's mother.
So the prosecution is all working to protect AD9?
The chief prosecutor is, at the very least.
This is all my fault. I'm the one who told Morita that Yagami-kun would be there. If I had only gone to Izumida instead.
Don't think like that. There's no knowing who's on what side. We can't trust anyone except ourselves.
But...
Can I say something real quick? I'm not sure I'm the best person to be defending Ayabe. Not against an enemy this powerful.
Well, what do you mean?
Agreed. Hoshino-kun can't handle the pressure. It has to be you, Yagami-san.
Oh, ha ha. Real funny.
This isn't a joke. We're dead serious.
Please, Yagami-san. We're going up against the people who murdered Emi-san. Do it for her. For Okubo-san.
And for Shintani-sensei.
It's time for you to show the world what you think is right.
No more running.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'll let Genda-sensei and Ayabe-san know right away. This is bound to make headlines. I can see it now. Disgraced lawyer Yagami-sensei makes his triumphant courtroom return.
All right, do we really need the disgraced part? But, all right. If they both agree, I'll defend Ayabe. Guess I'll need to start digging up some more evidence.